So recently, I came across this microwave motion sensor on Amazon. So at a first look, I thought it's the light with a built-in microwave sensor and I'm getting it at an amazing price. So I straight away bought that product and when I received it, I found that it was just the microwave motion sensor in which we can attach a load and we can control the appliances connected with it based upon the motion. But anyways, I tested that sensor and after testing, I realized that this motion sensor is far better than the regular PIR motion sensor that we are using for our projects. So I decided why not to make a detailed video for all those who are not at all aware about this sensor and let's compare it with the regular PIR motion sensor and see the results like which one we should consider for our projects or products. It's gonna be a really interesting video. So now if you're watching me for the very first time, well, you're missing a lot of educational and interesting content. So do subscribe this channel right now so that you don't miss the upcoming content in the field of IoT, electronics and automation. And that being said, let's start with the microwave motion sensor video. Bahut sahi sensor hai yaar, maza aa jayega. Let's get started. Before starting the video, let me tell you one really interesting and useful feature of our sponsor LTM, which is a PCB designer based software company, and that feature is called as design review. Using LTM, you can add any member to your project and after that, they can highlight any fault in the schematic or can report availability of components in the inventory on the PCB to your designer so that they can visualize these components and can work upon it to provide a smooth flow of PCB production even if they both are in any corner of the world. So that's the design review feature and even you can try out this and many other features of LTM for free by just clicking on the link mentioned in the description as you'll be getting an access to free trial version using that link. Now let's start with our video. Now let's start this video by discussing the working principle of both the sensors. So PIR, as the name suggests, works on passive infrareds. Means it can detect the warm body's movement within the detection range and triggers the signal pin. And once that warm body settles down in that environment, it stops sending the signal to the signal pin. So it's generally used for detecting the motions of human beings and animals. It won't be able to detect the movements of non-living objects. Also, passive infrared sensor like PIR sensor fails to work in the hot environments or hot regions. So that is the point you need to consider before using the sensor. Now generally the detection angle of this kind of sensor is from 90 degree up to 180 degree. Now one main point about the sensor is that the lens of the sensor need to be pointing towards the movement of that human being or animal. That means the sensor need to be in the line of sight for the movement. If the lens is covered by any plastic object or if the lens is behind any wall or inside the ceiling, it won't be able to detect any kind of motion because the sensor won't be able to receive the passive infrared radiations. So that's how the PIR sensor works. And now if we talk about the working principle of microwave sensors, then microwave sensors works on the principle of sonar in which the radiations are emitted by the transmitter and it is received by the receiver and the time taken by the signal from transmission to reception is calculated. So when any object comes into the detection range, it disrupts the signal which results in a time delay of the signal to get back to the receiver side. So this time delay is sensed by the sensor and it triggers the signal pin and this is how a microwave sensor detects any kind of motion. Now the amazing part of this kind of sensor is the detection angle of these sensors is 360 degree, means it can detect the motion from any angle. Now the best part or the wow factor of this sensor is even if the sensor is covered by some plastic body or even if the sensor is placed behind a thin wall or we can say inside the ceiling, it can still detect the motion through the walls, through the plastic object. So it not necessarily need to be placed in line of sight. We can hide this kind of sensor and use it for motion detection. It's kind of a spy gadget you can say, right? Where a person won't be able to recognize if there any kind of sensor installed inside the room. Scary, right? And as this sensor works on the microwave radiation, it is also suitable to use the sensor in the hot areas where the PIR sensor tends to fail. So yeah, those were the working principles of both the sensors. And after knowing about it, let us test both the sensor working live in action and let us test how much accurate both these sensors are. Let us test it out. So for the testing purpose, I got another microwave sensor, but this time in much smaller form factor from the local market at around 1000 rupees. You can get the similar kind of microwave motion sensors from Amazon ranging from 500 to 800 rupees. I'll leave the links down in the description of this video. So what I did is, on my left, I have attached a bulb with a PIR motion sensor, and on my right, I have attached the bulb with a microwave motion sensor. Now let me tell you that both these sensors are configured at their highest sensitivity. So let us test them with different kind of movements. So from this test, we can clearly see that the microwave sensors perform much accurately and responds quickly as compared to the PIR sensor. And also the microwave sensor is able to detect the motion from any angle and also through the objects. That is insane. Now I was a bit curious to test this sensor behind the wall or inside the ceiling. So what I did is, I removed one of the light from my ceiling, attach the sensor with that light, and after that I put that sensor inside the ceiling and close the light. But before installing that, I made some minor changes in the sensitivity, because this microwave sensor is so accurate that it can detect the micro movements, but I don't want to detect micro movements for this kind of light. So I just reduced the sensitivity a bit, and after I install it in the ceiling. So now let us see if this sensor works inside the ceiling or not. Let us test it out. Amazing. So this works perfectly fine under the ceiling as well, and literally no one will ever be able to recognize that there is any kind of motion sensor installed in your room, which is the best part of the sensor. Well, now if you're worrying about those microwave radiations emitted by the sensor may harm our human body, well then let me tell you that on the user manual it is clearly stated that the output of this high frequency sensor is less than 0.2 milliwatt, which is the 5000th part of the radiation that is emitted by the mobile phone. So you can see the clear difference, and with this we can be sure that the radiations emitted are safe to use at our home. So yeah, that was the video about the microwave sensor, and also try to cover the comparison of the microwave sensor with the regular PIR sensor. And well, do let me know in the comments, were you aware about this sensor before watching this video, or have you ever used this sensor yet? Well, do share your thoughts about the sensor down in the comments of the video. And also, video acha laga to do click the like button and tell YouTube algorithm that this video is definitely worth watching, and hence it will promote it with the other viewers as well. And also, you can share this video with your techie friend and let them know that your microwave sensor is kafi accurate for motion detection projects, and they should consider using this sensor for the next project. So yeah, that was it about the video. I wish all my YouTube family a very happy Diwali and a happy new year. And that being said, I'm just ending this video here and now. Just wait for my next video to explore, learn, share with me, techiesms.